Hi there, ladies and gentlemen. This is your friendly neighborhood Oxhorn, and here I am in Vault 88 doing a Let's Play for settlement building. I've had a lot of requests from people saying, hey, have you ever thought about just taking some time, setting it aside, and just recording a settlement building session? And sure, so why not? Let's try that. Let's see how it works. If you like episodes like these, be sure to let me know in the comments below so that I know that I can create more of these. Otherwise, I'll go back to what I typically do, which is provide a tutorial or something like that. So, and I'm lost. Let's see. What we're gonna do is... I really am lost. That's not the way. So, what we... Alright, so I built out the North Sector A and North Sector B. I built out Northeast Sector A, and I have not built Northeast Sector B. So I'm trying to get to Northeast Sector B, and this is not right. Because what I want to do is I want to build an underground shower slash pool facility. And something. There we go, finally. Alright, there we go. So this is the section that I have left unbuilt. You can see that it connects to the north sector over here. And I've built in every single room except this one. And so now let's build here. Alright, let's move the cone out of the way. And you can't actually scrap these things or move them using the settlement tool. So let's move that out of the way. All right, now we need to make sure that we work from here because we want it to be able to be wired with the electricity and we want the electricity to flow through the floors. So we need to build from here and not from over there. If we start building from over there, we could misgauge the tiles and then we could over or under build. So let's start by building into this room. So let's make the assumption that this and this connect and start going off into this room. So what's about the middle of the room? That's about the middle of the room. So we could probably do one, two, before we need to enter that room. Okay, so two tiles to enter that room. Let us go to the vault section and domestic. And we want just a regular windowed hallway. Actually, let's make it just a regular hallway. Like so. And then we're gonna need a three-way. Turn that around. And there we go. There's our three-way hallway. So that should lead down on in there. And now we can connect these two. So let's do that. Let's see, we can't turn a corner right there. So we need to go out one more and then we can turn a corner. So let's just get a regular hallway to push that out one more. And then we need a three-way to turn the corner. Actually, no, not a three-way. We need a corner. Then, trying to decide if I want any windows going that way or not. Yeah, I want one window going that way. So let's get one window. I really like these white rocks. I love these white marble-looking rocks. And then one more. Yeah, we've got room for one more. Two more. Oh no, you've got to be kidding me. Yes. Oh. Ho, ho. I was scared there for a minute, ladies and gentlemen. I thought after all of that, I would not be able to connect the sectors. Whew. Thank goodness I was wrong. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to build down and then I'm going to build up. That'll be the goal. But we need to remember that the pool actually has to have depth. So we need to leave... that's gonna be the floor right there. So we'll probably just go down one step and then build from there. So we need to go out one and then we'll go down a step. And then we can add the supports later. So just a regular hallway. Then a domestic stair. And this is tricky because one more domestic stair is going to bring us all the way down to the ground floor, which is not what we want. Yeah, you see that? It perfectly matches. So I guess we'll start building out this way. Okay, well, let's put a domestic doorway here. Now to get the domestic units to connect to the atrium units, we're gonna connect an atrium doorway to that utility doorway, which will allow us to place atrium floors. And walls. See? Now we can build out as we normally would. So, now it's just a little bit of work. Looks like I can go one more over before I start getting clipping issues. So that's going to have to be... Now there's no room in this build, in this little cave, for the atrium prefabs. I already tested them. Okay, we're getting close here. Let's see if one more corner will fit. Oh, and it doesn't. So we're gonna have to remove one. And there. We can turn in that way. So. This area right there is going to be the pool. Let's see, that's pretty much one spot. All right, to get the bottom of this pool, we're going to have to be pretty sneaky. So let's build one floor here. Then we're going to build a wall prefab with a roof like this. And we'll build that there. That's fine. Doesn't really matter. Then we'll go ahead and get there. That's actually better. That's what we want. So now we've got that going that way. Then we can go back into the atrium and get the floor wall combo. And that actually snaps to the bottom. And then we can remove that. And that will allow us to build the bottom of the pool. So now we just get to cracking. Looks like I won't have enough room because that's gonna clip. Yeah, that just barely clips. Is that enough to bother me? No, it's not enough. It is enough to bother me. So let's go ahead and put that down there. We'll have a 3-tile wide pool. Yeah, that sounds good. Oh, I want to save that for later. I want to have a window pointing out towards that exit over there. So we'll just wrap this around and... Oh! Is that the end? Oh, this goes up. So it's going to be a 3x3 pool. Looks that way. All right, looks like it's going to be a 3x3 pool because we don't want any clipping. And here's the one at the window. Yeah, I can see out there. Let's remember to put a window in there while we're at it. Probably needs to be reinforced. And then we can finish this off with a corner piece. and then a simple floor. Okay, so that gives us a square pool. That's really all the room we had for. So let's finish this out with some floors. And then we're going to put one more here to give us a place to snap the water to. Then let's go to miscellaneous and get our water tiles. See how that looks. Oh, I love it when a plan comes together. Oh, that's so great. Okay, next up we need to build a second floor. And let's see, is that gonna clip? I think that's gonna clip, so. But that's okay, because we need to put a stairwell there anyway. So let's get rid of this. And then I'm going to add a domestic doorway end cap here. But I'm not really gonna put it there because I wanna show you something. I wanna put a ladder system down there. But the way that these snap is always to that side. So if I want it to go the other direction, I'm gonna have to remove this. Put down, let's just say that for now, then remove that, then put down a doorway there so that it goes the correct direction, then remove that, go back to my stairs, and now it should finally snap. But I don't actually want a doorway. So I'm gonna remove that, go back to atrium, grab my floor, and voila. I now have a stairway. Now let's block this off, simply using the atrium wall mid. Oh no, that's not gonna work. All right, looks like we gotta try this a tricky way. Let's remove that. Move that, go over here, go to floor, place a corner there, place that there, place another one there, go back and remove that, go back to domestic, grab the door, then go back to domestic and grab the stair. Back here, remove that, go back to atrium, grab a floor, place the floor. Remove the doorway, place that there. All right, looks like we'll just have to have that open. But here, we should probably place a floor with a corner. There. Yeah, that looks good. All right, let's close in this wall. All right, now we placed these atrium floors temporarily just so that we could put down our water. So let's remove these and replace them with the floors that we want. Okay, now to do the ceiling, it's gonna be tricky. So what I wanna do is I built this up here, this stairway right here, because I want to build on top of the pool. I want to build an exercise facility or bathroom. I haven't decided yet. Probably one giant room with both in it. And to do that, you know, I don't want the bottom of the domestic tile unit or the bottom of the room units to be the ceiling, because I think there would be a gap. But you know what? Before we move any further, we should test it, because if you look under there, the bottoms look pretty good. And if there's no gap, then we should just be able to use that without having to build another ceiling. So let's grab a doorway. Then let's go to lavatory and grab a doorway corner, like that. Let's look at the seam. Okay, that seam looks pretty good. Yeah, there's no need to build another roof. No need at all. So then let's just plan out how we want this to work. I've got 2, 4, 5. I've got a 5 tile width and a 2, 4, 5. I've got a 5 tile depth. Not including this over here, so that could probably be pushed out one if I left that open for a hallway. And I'm going to need 2 rooms. I want 1 bathroom, and then I need an exercise slash gym facility. Because I don't think I have enough room to kind of build it up in here. Because that's going to come flush to the wall. Yeah, this is... Well, it looks like I might have more room for one more floor. Well, let's try it. Let's see how one more floor looks. So let's grab a doorway because we're planning on snapping another stairway to that doorway. Hopefully this snaps. Finally! Oh my gosh. Oh, it was miserable. But let's take a look at this. Ooh. That's gonna be rough. So it's only gonna work if I immediately start building around. We don't need this anymore. Okay. Well, let's build the lavatory sector, and then let's build the exercise facility. So now that we have that there, we can just go back to domestic. Place that there. Go back to lavatory. Place that there. And then we're gonna want a corner piece. I'll show you how this works. Since this is gonna round a corner, we're gonna have that. Because this needs to go right there. See how that works? There would have been a huge gap right there have we not used the lavatory corner piece, which connects those together. All right, let's finish this. Let's fill this in. Bingo! Sweet! We've got a lavatory! And then a stairway leading on up to the exercise facility. But first, we need to finish this by closing this off. And this is actually going to make use of the trick that I tried to show you earlier. So the atrium pieces do not like single-story structures. So they make it very difficult for you to build a floor, wall, and roof all in one go. So to get this to work, we're going to attach an atrium wall top to an atrium wall bottom, and then go over to hanging floor. But this is really bulky, we don't want that. But the only reason we put it there is so that we can snap to it a regular floor. And we had to go all the way around, but we did get it to work. Now, wait a minute. I forgot to put the X in. Alright, so I do want to have access to this tunnel back here. And I can't build it from this floor because that's the pool. So it has to be there. Which means I need a doored cornerway. So I've got a door. Let's put a wall. There we go. And that actually looks like a seamless thing. This is actually the floor of the lavatory units, and this is just the bottom of an atrium floor. But they work together beautifully. Oh, that's so great. Okay, well, now that we've got this, we need to find a way down. So, let's actually make it utility. Utility? So we're gonna have to do this in a roundabout way. Let's actually remove that, go back to atrium, go to atrium floors. Snap that in there, and then go to utility. All right, that should work. Why didn't I want to snap before? I'm not sure why that didn't want to snap before, but it's snapping now. And then that. There we go. Gosh, that took forever. And you won't be able to do that on consoles, sadly. I had to use the Place Anywhere mod just to get that to work. Doesn't make a lick of sense. Okay, now I've got this ugly corner. And the best way to go about that is going to be to remove that. I need to go back to atrium floor. That fixes that part, but now I have this big ugly thing there, so let's go to inner corner mid. And then that snaps right in there, looking good. Let's get a door in there. Looks like we still don't have buttons out here. Not sure why that is. But at least we got that working together now. And we have access to this nice little tunnel that leads all the way back here. Cool. Alright, so what we're missing here are supports. We need to place some supports all the way around the swimming pool. Otherwise it won't look good. So let's do that right now. I find that these tend to work better than the twofers. I don't know why. I'm gonna leave that open. There, now it's fully supported, and it makes sense. Great! Okay, now that I have the Place Anywhere mod turned on... Ooh, what's this? Oh... It's clashing with the wall bottom. That means I pushed it up too far, so let's take that down a notch. Oh yeah, look at that! See, I accidentally snapped it too far. There. That should take care of things. Bingo! Right, so... This leads back... There. This leads up there. We've got our bathroom. Okay. So now we just need our exercise facility. And there's no room that way. So we need to build... That way. Into this corner over here. Sweet, I can do that. So, let's find a corner. Let's find one with windows. Let's put the window up that way. And now let's round the corner. And now we can start building. Basically, we have this entire area to build with. Now that we're out here. So, what tile set should we use for an exercise room? Think I may need to go with common, ladies and gentlemen. So, before we can do that, we need to go and get a doorway end cap. Now, we can use the common Great! Let's build on out. I don't want to make myself more work than I can handle, so I'll kind of keep it small. Because remember, every room you build, you're gonna have to decorate. There we have it, ladies and gentlemen. Nice view of the trail leading out there. Got a bathroom. Got our swimming pool. And an exit to the outdoors. Oh! Oh, that doesn't look good. It's because I used those floors as ceiling tiles. Well, it's on the outside, no one's gonna see it. I'd much rather have shorter ceilings. Alright, so now we need to put supports for the rest of this overhang. We did a pretty good job of maximizing our use of this room. Not perfect. This is probably the only room where I'm not maximizing complete use of it. Looks like you could do one more line here, and then one more line around this corner. And then looks like up there I've got room for one teeny tiny more line. But you know what? I'm okay with it. Let's put our supports. looking pretty doggone good, if I do say so myself. Now I just have to go decorate it. Looks like we need to put a support in here. I'll show you how that works. There we go. And then a support for our support. Bingo! Oh man, I'm so happy. It worked out. I think I'm gonna put one more ladder in there, and then I need to decorate it up with towels and some warning signs, maybe a pile of towels over here. And then up here, I'm gonna have showers and then toilets. I'll probably have to make another room in here just for toilets, or find a toilet stall mod. I don't know of a toilet stall mod. If any of you know of a toilet stall mod, let me know so that I can put some toilet stalls in there. And then up here, I'll put a bunch of those cycle bikes in one corner and weight machines in the other. Oh yeah, this is the perfect size. I'm glad I didn't make this bigger. That would have been too much to decorate. But I'll have a line of weightlifting machines, and I'll have a line of the cycle bikes, and then some towels and decorations on the wall, and then we'll call that one done. Sweet. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining me for this Let's Play of Fallout 4, where all we did was settlement building. I had a lot of fun, and I'm glad that you were able to come with me. What did you think? Did you learn anything? Did you find out a little bit more about the creative process, so to speak? The water is so murky that it's hard to see out the window, but you can see a few things. If you like segments like this, let me know in the comments below so that I can make more of them. As always, thank you so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe for more Fallout 4 content like this, because your subscriptions keep this channel alive. And thank you all so much for watching.